Item 6D.
Item 6D is a resolution of the City of Margate, Florida, approving a 2% base wage adjustment for the period from October 1, 2021 through September 30th, 2022 for all non-bargain personnel, providing for an effective date. This resolution is before you for your consideration this evening.
What's the wish of the commission?
Motion to approve.
Second.
Any discussion besides me? Okay. I'm going to ask if there's anybody from the public first.
Yes. In Zoom, would you like to comment on this item?
Go right ahead.
Thank you. Just curiosity. So can you just clarify who this raise is for? Is it for the city employees? Is it for the commission? Who is this for?
City manager, please.
Chairman. Dale Curtis, city manager.
Hi.
This base wage adjustment includes all non-bargain personnel. It includes part-time personnel, senior management, and commissioners.
Okay, so then if this is the case, what I have to say is I think that this is sad because in the economy, the way that it is, anybody that has a home that is insured has got slammed with massive insurance rates. Actually, not only your homes, but if you're in an association, it's got raised there. So there are so many ways that many of us have been hit with having to pay increases in so many things. There are so many people that are can't pay their rent, that are living on the streets. I mean, on and on and on and on and on. Seniors that can't afford their medication. So I'm hoping that maybe this, all of these things will be taken into consideration, and possibly that 2% can go toward the really needy things that are going on in the city. The homeless, the seniors that can't afford their meds or food. I've seen that, which is really nice. Several places have the food pantries, but with the amount of people that are coming and stuff like that, I just would feel that it is in the best interest of the residents for this not to happen. Thank you.
Thank you. Anybody else in the public?
Nobody else in Zoom at this time, Mayor.
All right. I'm going to make a statement because on some level, I happen to agree with Mrs. Burke. I understand that unions have as part of their contracts increases. That's what unions do. I also understand there are a number of city employees who are not part of a union and they are called non-bargained for. My issue is with the combination of a step plan and then a 2% raise. I believe either or. If you're maxed out and you're not going to get a raise, I understand the 2%. If you're on a step plan that will give you 5%, I have a problem with adding the 2% on top of it. For me, it needs to be either or. And I agree that at a time when we did not raise the fire assessment because we understood people were having hard times, I think there are times that you just hold off on those kinds of raises. We did that many years ago, and then when we were able to, we made up for it. But I have a problem with thousands of dollars of raises that also have a 2% on top of that. I think it's the wrong time for it. Commissioner Ruzzano?
Yeah, I agree with some things that Ms. Parker said. But I just want people to know the non-bargaining are probably some of the lower paid people in the city, and the senior staff, I kind of look at them as the captains of their team. And I know last year, just to mention one, I think Mark Collins came up with something in a way to save the city money, a nice sum of money, by looking into a leasing program. I know that Richard from the building department's come up with ways to flow the building department, getting it better flowing than it used to be. I know Kurt, he's probably got more wisdom than anybody in this room, and he'll tell you that. So, you know, the people that are here, you know, I appreciate everything they do, and they're the leaders of the team. And I understand what you're saying about the step and the raise. And I understand what Ms. Baraka said, but Ms. Baraka, I just want to let you know that we have $10 million that we're going to be figuring out what the best thing to do with it is in the city. And I've talked about in the past, maybe making the whole city Wi-Fi, which is part of an infrastructure project that we might be able to do to maybe ease the burden on the residents. So I've heard what you said. I appreciate it. And I like what you said earlier as well. But, these people, you get what you pay for. I've said that before, and I appreciate what everybody does. And if we did have the money to pay everybody per merit, might be a little bit different, but I appreciate what everybody does. And thank you.
City manager, did you change your mind?
No, just one point of clarification. I understand the point that you're trying to make, Mayor, in terms of dollars, but you mentioned that the step plan is at 5%, but I just want to make sure that for the public knows that it's not a 5% step plan. It is, it's actually in most cases less than 4%.
Okay, but my point was meaning that we're not talking a 2% raise to keep up with inflation. In most cases, we're talking then what you're saying between 5% and 7%, because a 5% or 4% rather step plan would mean a 6% raise. I think there's a time and place for that. I recognize the fact that people do a lot in their job description. I also know that when people get additional job responsibilities, this city pays them for it. I can tell you that in other government agencies, when you inherit more work, you get a thank you, but that's about all you get. At some point, you have to look at and balance this. Would I say to you that people who make less, I certainly don't want to hurt? Absolutely. But when it gets to the point where we're talking $5,000, $6,000, $7,000, $8,000 a year raise, I can't swallow that. And having worked for a government agency that certainly didn't do that to people who were very deserving as well, I just, and this is not a comment I've just come up with this time, I've said this multiple times, our neighboring cities don't have step plans. They have merit performance-based ratings. Perhaps we need to look at that. Now, will I turn around and also tell you that I will propose raising that amount for the city clerk? I absolutely will, because I find him an unsung hero that we don't say a lot about. And there's never a time, no matter what day, and I will say that for all employees, that they don't answer the phone. They absolutely do. But again, I understand if you've run out of steps, then you don't wind up with a raise unless you get the 2%. But the 2% on top of a step, that's hard for me as having been a public employee to swallow. Commissioner Simone.
Thank you. I noticed that the commissioners are tied into this. Is there a way of separating that? I don't know what cost savings that would be, but it is even worth it. But, that's a way to save a few dollars.
$600. $600.
Oh, $600 per?
$600.
So I don't know. I don't agree with the commission being tied into the employees, because I don't consider us really an employee, consider us a public servant, service personnel. So I don't agree with the commissioners being part of this. So I would like to pull them out.
Okay. Any other comments from the commission?
Yes.
Oh, okay. You didn't press your button so I can see it.
Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, I don't necessarily disagree with you, Commissioner Simone. I know when this came up last time, I did vote for it, but I was opposed to the commissioners receiving the 2%. I voted for it because I didn't want to penalize staff. So if there is a way to separate it, I would certainly consider that. I did take the 2%, but as promised, I gave it back to the community. Just of what I can think of off the top of my head, I donated to 501c3 Tough Start. I donated to the PTA, to the principal that came up for one of the Broward County schools here at one of our meetings in Margate. The police explorers, I've paid for police details, and I've paid for toys being distributed to kids in the city, far, far exceeding the $600 by a lot. But I would entertain pulling it from the commission if there's a way to do it. But if we can't and it's going to penalize staff, then I won't.
I don't think you can do this though. But any other comments from the commission? Anybody else from public?
Not in Zoom at this time, Mayor.
Please. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't see you.
I believe before all you all were here, the commission was not tied into the city. So I don't know how the raises were back then, but you can do it again. There's no reason your raises have to be tied in with the city employees. You're not a city employee. You guys are basically volunteers for the city that make money off of the residents. So there's no way that you should be tied in with city raises. So whoever's city manager, whoever, figure it out and don't be tied in, because I can guarantee you the other city commissioners are not tied in with their employee raises. Figure it out. I mean, there's got to be a way, Kale, to get them out. And if you don't want to take the raise, say, I don't want to take the raise. I believe Commissioner Simone has said I refused the raise and she hasn't gotten it, right? You don't have to just donate your money. Just don't give it, don't take it. Am I right?
Commissioner Rosanna?
Commissioners in the past were always tied in with senior management. It was, yes, it was. There was a commissioner at the time that wanted to make a mark and say, I don't think we should take it. But I can assure you this, I've never worked so hard having this job, and I'm only speaking for myself. I've never donated so much money since having this job, and I'm the lowest paid probably employee in the city.
But that's your choice, you're a commissioner.
But you know what? It's my choice to be here, correct? Right. And it's also the effectiveness of what I get done. What we got done at that last party that we just had, or whatever you want to call it, we've introduced people to our city manager at that party. I know I did. That work hand in hand with the governor, work hand in hand with the senators, and they said they would help us. You can get somebody to sit up here. Yeah, they could sit up here and say, I don't want the money. I've seen it before. But you know what? It's being effective in your city, getting things done in your city, and you should get what you're paid for. I bust my butt here. I do a lot. I look at a lot of things that happen in the city, and you know, I don't think that I should be not offered the 2% that everybody else is. I work just as hard and I am a full-time employee. If you look at the paycheck, we are employees of the city. So people that say we're not, that's not true.
Okay, but you don't need to be tied in with them. You can get a raise at a different time. Why every time do the city employees get a raise, you get a raise?
So do you want me to come up here and say how great I've done for the city and ask for a $10,000 raise? That would be better.
I would like you.
Then when would you want me to do it?
I would like somebody to give you an evaluation and then get a raise.
I did have an evaluation last election and I got more votes than anybody in the city of Margate ever did. I think that's my evaluation.
Okay, well, that's fine. Then you'll get a raise.
Thank you.
No, you'll not get a raise now, when the employees. I'm saying get a raise. Why don't the commissioners get a raise at a different time? Why do you have to get a raise every time the city employees get a raise?
I just told you why. We're tied into them.
Everybody's not the same as you, Tommy.
Okay, well, I don't know what to say.
Everybody's not the same as you.
Well.
I mean, I don't know what to tell you. I'm sorry there's not five Tommies sitting up there. You know, I mean, Simone busts her butt too, but she doesn't take a car allowance. She doesn't take a phone, you know.
That's not true. The city pays for Commissioner Simone's phone.
Right, but I don't take, per se, phone allowance. Where I get a new phone every year or every other year.
I've never gotten a phone.
And I don't take any money for the phone. The city has purchased probably, I think my phone was $100 that the city purchased.
Which I'm sure she'll leave on her desk if she leaves.
That is correct. It is not my phone. It belongs to the city. So I do not take a monthly phone allowance.
There's a way to untie you guys from getting a raise when the city employees get a raise. And I'm sure Kale knows how to do it because he's awfully quiet over there in the corner. Have a nice night.
Thank you.
In terms of the current salary for the commissioners,
I really don't need to hear from you.
That's fine, ma'am. I'm still going to respond because I actually...
Mrs. Van.
Ma'am, may I speak? Because I actually agree with most of what you said. The reason why I chose to take the 2% and Commissioner Simone didn't, and that's her choice, and I'm not going to knock her for it. But I actually also agree with Mrs. It's shocking that I'm agreeing with a lot of people that I usually disagree with.
Please.
But I'd rather give it to seniors, give it to children, give it to organizations that could use the money. When Commissioner Simone didn't take the 2%, it didn't go out into the community. Not knocking her, that's her choice. That's how those funds went out. Maybe she did donate separately. I'm not here to say that. I'm just saying that I felt taking it and giving it back to the community was best suited. Okay. In terms of the current salaries that we get, I mean, what if somebody wants to run against me for office, but they don't make any money? How are they going to give up what they do to come here? Because I know that, like you, I work 30, 40 hours a week easily for the city. So how is somebody that maybe is not as fortunate as some people, how are they going to run for office if the pay is zero? So just think about it from that aspect. But aside from the outburst, I don't disagree with you. And I'm probably going to vote no on it. So...
Any other comments from anybody? Ah, okay.
Resident Margate, first of all, who's going to refuse a raise? Nobody. You work hard, you do what you're supposed to do, period. Now, city employees are all treated alike with this 2%. Oh, by the way, question, is it a cost of living? No, it's just a 2% raise.
We've now changed the name because it really doesn't matter. Apparently, as of this time, it should change this name.
I mean, I used to work for the airlines back in the day. We were unionized, we never turned down a raise. We fought for the raise to get the raise. You gentlemen up there and ladies, naturally, I think in my personal view, you should be tied into it. Absolutely. Because it's a fair 2% across the entire board. And it says non-bargaining personnel, which means it's not you. That's the union people that they're bargaining with. So you're the people that get that raise. Refusing it is one thing that's your choice. If you feel like you don't want it because you want to maybe score some points with the personnel or the people of Margate, that's a good way. I don't recognize it that way. Because I think anything that I'm entitled to get, working all these hours, and I know most of you up there do that, your time is taken up and you put your effort in to do what you're supposed to do. So, City Commissioner, welcome aboard. Take your 2% and congratulations.
Thank you. Commissioner Simone?
Thank you. I'm not going to, deny the non-bargain personnel because the commissioners are in here. I think that the non-bargaining, we've given the 2% to everybody else in the city. And I think these employees deserve it like everybody else has gotten it in the city. So to vote no on this and deny them, I don't think is the correct thing to do. However, I would like to make a motion to amend this and take out the commissioners.
I'll second it.
Comments by the commission? Anybody from the public? Just on the amendment.
Nobody in Zoom at this timer.
All right. Please call the roll.
This is on the motion to amend the original motion to remove the commissioners from the proposed 2%.
Just for the record, so that you all hear this. When I sat up here years ago, the city commission didn't get a raise. This came up before any one of these people sitting here did that. So if we're going to talk about the hidden word of greed, we need to look at the people before us who thought they went after everything they possibly could. And I will just leave it at that because I want it understood. Nobody up here voted for that. However, what the city commission used to like to do is just put it out there and vote for themselves and not really advertise much of it and make it part of the budget prior to that. So just for so that you understand the history from what I remember. Go right ahead.
Yeah, when this fails, I'm going to make a motion that if you want to take it, we'll vote on it individually and you either take it or you don't take it.
All right, please call the roll. All right, so as just to repeat
it. This is still on the motion to amend the original motion, so if to remove the commissioners from the 2% increase.
Okay, please call the roll.
Commissioner Caggiano.
No.
Commissioner Simone.
Yes.
Commissioner Ruzzano.
No.
Vice Mayor Arserio.
Yes.
Mayor Schwartz.
Gotta love it. Gotta love it. I will be fine with yes, but it's going to be wind up back on the city commission. I'm back up on the agenda anyhow. So, you know, to me, that's a moot point.
Why is it coming back up?
I guarantee.
But now you are voting to amend the motion to remove the commissioners.
Remove the commissioners.
And then you'll vote on the.
I got it. I understand perfectly.
Right. So,
all right.
So Mayor, is that a yes vote?
That's a yes.
Thank you.
All right. So the motion to amend the original motion to remove the commissioners passed 3-2. So you currently have a amended motion before you to approve the resolution with the removal of the commissioners from the 2% increase.
Correct. Now on the original motion.
As amended.
So it's what you've got in front of you.
As amended.
So you are to, the only thing left to do is call the roll.
I understand, call the roll. Oh, wait a minute, I still got numbers up here. Are you guys still looking to talk? Commissioner, Vice Mayor. City Manager.
Right, so just so we're clear, the motion before you now is a resolution approving a 2% base wage adjustment for all non-bargaining personnel, including senior management, part-time personnel, but we are now excluding the commission from this resolution.
That's what I believe this is.
Okay.
And unless I amend it to just do either or, we're going to be voting again. So I'll just cast my vote when the time comes. Please call the roll.
Commissioner Caggiano?
No.
Commissioner Simone?
Yes.
Commissioner Ruzzano?
No.
Vice Mayor Arserio?
Yes.
Mayor Schwartz?
And I'm going to vote no because my issue was the double raise. No.
So the amended motion fails 3-2.
And this had nothing to do with the commissioner being pulled out. It had to do with what I started to speak about to start with. Just no one.
So as this motion has failed, all non-bargaining personnel will not be receiving the same 2% as the rest of the bargaining members. Well, unless somebody
on the prevailing side
decides to bring it back and discuss
now brings us to bring it back. My vote's specifically about what I said to start with, the double raise. So unless someone on the prevailing side brings it up, nobody who is not part of the union is going to get the raise.
There are a number of employees that are maxed out that would not be receiving a double
and
raise that are now.
Right, and I don't want to do that to them. So I could have amended it, I guess, to say that we do either or, but I don't know. And now you're going to wait for me to bring this back up and pass the gavel in order to do it. I know the rules. All right. So in that case, because again, I don't want to hurt people who will never who are maxed out, because people on the STEP program are still getting their raise. It's people who have hit the wall who will get no raise. My issue was people on a STEP program getting the STEP and the raise, but I don't want to stop people who will get no raise. So therefore, here, congratulations. I'm going to bring this back up as a member of the prevailing side to allow people, I'm going to amend it altogether. I'm going to allow people who are not getting a raise to absolutely get the 2%. Tell me what I have to say.
First, you need to make a motion to reconsider.
Okay.
The amended motion, which just failed.
I'll make a motion to reconsider the amended motion that just failed. It takes a second, people.
This is for the...
To bring it back so then we can have... No, this is just to bring it back, period. Then you have to have that conversation.
Right. Yeah.
Otherwise, nobody's getting... nobody who... Yeah, of course you can second. You can second. You can keep the gavel.
Second it.
Okay. So currently you have a motion to reconsider the amended motion regarding the 2% for all non-bargaining employees in your management, excluding city commissioners. You have a motion and a second on the motion to reconsider at this time, Mr. Vice Mayor.
So any comments from the-
Vice Mayor, can you please speak into the mic? I'm sorry. Yep.
Thank you. Any comments from the commission?
I do.
Go ahead.
I'm gonna say this is a stupid political game that some people are doing. It's very obvious. It's horrible what's going on from both of you. And I just don't agree with it. And you're going to hurt these people because of that. Horrible.
I voted to give them the raise.
Yeah, but you know what, Antonio? The way you went about it for $600, I mean, to please a couple people, that was really the right move. Think about it. Think about what you did. Really wasn't cool.
I brought it up last year. So this is not the first time I brought it up. Every year I've brought this up.
That's fine.
Stuff is still there. And I certainly said I don't want to hurt the employees by doing this. So,
and I put it back up because I don't want to hurt the employees. I just want people to understand that I think we have to change the way we do this. If it's merit, then it's merit. But a step plan and something that winds up with up to $8,000 during these times is tough. And I've said that year after year too. So I'm not any different than that. But will I let them not get a raise? No, I will vote to let them get the raise, because there's nothing I can do. I don't want to hurt the people who don't get. But I want it understood that we need to look at a better way to do this, whether it's merit-based, as the cities around us do. There's just got to be a better way.
Yeah, I don't disagree with you in the future. I absolutely think it should be merit-raised. I don't think that you should get a step or get it just to get it. But at the end of the day, this is going to affect about 80 employees, and I went on the record voting to give them a raise. So I will vote to give them a raise.
I brought it back up, but I just wanted to make my point understood. The person who works really hard shouldn't be that you get it no matter what, whether you show up to work and do a job. It just shouldn't be double stacked like that. I don't think it started out to be double stacked like that. But that's how it comes out now. And I've had an issue with it from day one. Other governmental agencies don't do it that way. Other cities don't do it that way. So, city manager?
I was going to say, any other comments?
From your meeting.
From the commission?
Number two, though. I don't know.
She has the numbers. All right,
yeah. City manager. You see it?
Who's next? City manager.
Thank you. How do you refer to presiding officer?
Vice Mayor.
So the intent of this resolution is to treat all employees essentially the same, keep them on the same playing field between the police union, the fire union, the civilian union. They're all a part of an established step plan, and all are a part of an established collective bargaining agreement that provides for a 2% base wage adjustment effective October 1st. The non-bargaining personnel are a part of an established step pay plan as well. This is coming before you to provide them the same benefit that all bargain for personnel are achieving. What I can, you know, please don't take this as a threat on behalf of the staff or whatnot, but if we go down the path of looking at changing that, I can almost assure you that a fourth bargaining unit will start to form. And that's not to say we continue to do things the way we've been doing them. Through the collective bargaining process, we are effectuating changes to employee benefits that are providing long-term savings to the city. So again, you know, the intent of this resolution, this base wage adjustment is to keep the non-bargain force staff on the same playing field as the bargain force staff. Thank you.
Commissioner Ruzzano.
Keller Margate, Commissioner, City Employees.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so then from what you just said, then it's not all the employees, okay? And I think it was just a horrible charade what you guys did. I'm all for helping these people out, but that move was bad. It was really bad. You know, that's coming from three people here that collect the insurance, correct? But don't take it?
No.
Yeah.
No?
Yeah.
No? Yes? No? Yeah. You don't take it?
No, never have.
You don't get the insurance money?
Nope.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
Insurance, yeah. An insurance subsidy, but I don't take the.
And you know what? You're
that's
gonna.
That's what he said.
You're, but yeah, you'll take $600 from him. Take $600 from me. Horrible. It's really a bad move. It just shows that there's no unity up here. It really does. It was a bad move. I understand what Casey did. It was very good. It was clever. He did it. He pulled it off. I'm proud of you. No, but you know what? It's just, you know, sometimes they want to be employees. Sometimes they don't want to be employees. And it's just right now they just prove that we are not employees, which is horrible. But you did it. That's a nice move. And you know what? It wasn't worth the $600. I'm not going to fight for not to give it to them. But it was just they took it from him, who's an employee, and you took it from me, who's an employee, which is not good.
Okay, so I'll amend it again to put it back in for all. I fully expected it to come back up as a separate item.
Go ahead and amend it.
Well, right now you're still on a motion to reconsider.
And you're running the meeting right now. So.
Okay, I don't see any lights lit, so I will ask if there's any comments from the public.
Not on this. This is just a ministerial act on your part, because all you're doing right now is
bringing it back up.
If you want to bring it back.
Oh, okay. Well, I believe I seconded that.
Correct.
They didn't vote to bring it back.
Correct.
Up.
So it's a motion and second. Now you have to vote on the motion to reconsider.
So then at this time, Joseph, let's call the roll.
So wait a second. Can this come back to be amended again?
Can you?
So this
can
is,
you clearly tell me what we're voting for on this? And I want to make sure we're voting the right way.
This is on the motion to reconsider the amended resolution that failed. And the amended resolution that failed excluded the city commissioners from the 2% raise.
Well, then so
but the individual on the prevailing side who voted, you know, no, made the motion to reconsider. So at this point in time, you're deciding whether or not you want to reconsider the amended motion that failed.
Amendment could be made.
Correct.
Right. Okay. But you got to bring it on the table or nobody's getting ready.
Well, I can't bring it back because I wasn't on the.
No, but I already did. Now you have to vote to allow it.
I will, but. It should come back, which
then you.
But I can't bring it back.
No, I just did it, and he just seconded it.
Anyone on the prevailing side could make a motion to reconsider. There were three votes against the amended motion, and those are Commissioner Caggiano, Commissioner Ruzzano, Mayor Schwartz. Mayor Schwartz made the motion to reconsider the amended motion that failed. So right now, all you're voting on is whether or not you want to reconsider the amended motion. If this motion passes, then you can discuss that amended motion again.
And okay. You were on the prevailing side as well.
No, I was not on that one.
Yes, no, but this is now this one. Bring it back.
This is just the motion to reconsider. Correct. You haven't voted on it yet.
Correct.
So you need to vote.
Call the roll, Joseph.
That'll answer the questions.
Voting to
bring it back on
the
table.
Back up to discuss again.
Correct.
All right.
Commissioner Caggiano.
Yes.
Commissioner Simone.
Yes.
Commissioner Ruzzano.
Yes.
Vice Mayor Arserio.
Yes.
Mayor Schwartz.
Yes.
Okay. All right. So right now you have before you the resolution that was originally presented as amended, and that amendment took the commissioners out from the 2%. Since the motion is over, the motion reconsidered, the mayor made the vice mayor can pass the gavel back to the mayor. And you have before you the amended motion as it failed the first time.
So since it totally failed, it doesn't have to be somebody on the prevailing side on the part.
No,
anybody can now say this.
Right. You're back before.
Totally failed.
Well, so anybody can say correct. That they want to make a motion to have employees of the city be joined with other employees as opposed to being discriminated against.
I guess so. That's
yeah. Yeah, I'd like to make that motion.
All right.
You might want to selectively suggest who those people are,
so,
though.
So so you're making a motion to amend the motion that failed to put the city commissioners back into.
That's what he's doing.
Yeah, that's okay. What I want to do.
Okay,
we're all employees. We should all be treated the same.
All right. So is there a second?
So, yeah, you need a second.
Yeah, no, I'm waiting.
Second.
Thank you.
All right. So just for the record. The current motion that's before you will include all non-bargain employees, including senior management, city commission,
it's
and
the
everything
original,
as presented the, in the original resolution.
The original.
So now we're voting on the original motion.
The original one.
Okay, go ahead.
It's the original one before all the gate.
All right, so.
If it was to remain separated, the commission can still vote separately if they want to give themselves a 2% raise, correct?
Why would you?
Well, you can go to HR and tell
about the different.
Why would you do that now? This is not. It's
I'm
all,
not
it's
suggesting that.
It's back to the original. You know what? As has happened before, anyone who chooses not to take it will have that conversation with the city manager. How's that? You live with that, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you. All right. Any other comments? Anybody? Jeff?
Nobody in Zoom at this time, Mayor.
All right. So you're basically voting on the original amendment before all of this, original motion before any of this. Please call the roll.
This is just on the bargaining, the non-bargaining
correct.
Employees, not it's, the commission.
No. It includes no. all non-bargaining employees, including the city commission, all senior staff. It's the original resolution as presented.
The very original okay. one. Please call the roll.
Commissioner Caggiano.
Yes.
Commissioner Simone.
Yes.
Commissioner Ruzzano.
Yes.
Vice Mayor Arserio.
No.
Mayor Schwartz.
Yes, because I'm not going to hurt my city commission as I've been told I was trying to do.
And the motion passes 4-1, so the original resolution as presented is passed.
All right, with that in mind then, meeting adjourned. Thank you all for being here.